Can I ask a question before, if there is any time? Yes.
Sure, yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
So I have like question, what is the most ethical thing to do? And I don't have answer for it.
From Buddhist perspective, ethics are basically restraint from harm, you know, like not harming on purpose. So, you know, it's basically physically, verbally, and mentally trying to avoid negative actions. And the reason is because it would be like one hand cutting the other. It's like it doesn't directly hurt this hand, but it hurts the whole system, which makes everything weaker. You know, and we're all connected in this way, like different parts of the body, even though the different parts of the body aren't the same, they're related. And so your own ethics, I think, are, you know, it's often that we don't have the same ethics as the people around us. And asking what is fair to hold people to if they don't have your same belief system. And I think secular ethics are very related to Buddhist ethics because it's like, is it fair to do something that harms another? You know, just in a secular world, just justice, law, and order, like, is it fair? And I think the answer is no, it never is. And so then, is it okay to ask people not to do actions that harm others? I think it is.
Yeah,
That's
sometimes actions
more,
that you do
yeah.
to others are benefit them but hurt others. For example, if I take, I don't know, let's say eating meat. Okay? So by eating meat, somebody else is like killing an animal. Maybe I should kill the animal if I want to eat the meat and prevent him from killing.
I see what you're
So
saying. Yeah.
like it's getting so complicated always.
Yeah.
And how you suggest, I don't believe that you can give me in one sentence how do I solve this problem, but how do you suggest me to approach this issue of complex issues of ethics?
Yeah, I mean, the first thing always is what is your deepest motivation? Not what's your surface motivation, but like your deepest motivation. So the surface motivation, say, for eating meat would be I'm used to it because that's how I grew up, and I get tired and weak if I don't eat meat, and I don't know how to cook properly so that I have complex proteins in my vegetarian diet. And so, of course, I could learn these things, but life is busy and I'm just going to have this beef. That's the surface reason, which could be challenged, right? You could challenge that surface decision. The deep decision, though, could be I am genuinely working on my spiritual path and I've tried to eat differently. And when I do so, I'm too weak to pursue my spiritual path. And so I know that I actually don't need to eat meat every meal or every day, but if I eat it every 2 weeks, it makes me a stronger and better practitioner. And so I'll treat it as medicine and source it ethically, you know, from people that are conscious about not torturing the animals, not transporting them long distances, organic, grass-fed, yada yada. You know, and so you're knowing it's not a perfect decision, but
Yes.
it's a good decision for you that is a step up from where you were. And you ask, you know, is it better to kill it myself, sort of to take responsibility in a way so someone else doesn't have to do it? And that makes a lot of sense. But from the perspective of karma, the more direct the action, the more direct the result. People who are butchers, of course, if everyone stopped eating meat, there would stop being butchers. But you stopping eating meat is not going to stop the butcher from having that profession. Right? They're going to keep having that profession whether you eat meat or not. They already have that habituation. But, you know, so you directly killing the animal is actually a heavier karma than them killing it.
Yeah, but
Spooky,
for
right?
example, in this option, directly I affecting my karma, but I'm also directly affecting his karma by not doing it.
It's like you're only responsible for your own choices. On one level, but on the other level, you know that your choices have an influence on other people's choices. So you can't pretend that it doesn't have an effect on their choices, but the main thing you're making sure is clear is your own decisions and your own choices. Because in samsara, there is absolutely no form of consumption, food included, that doesn't include harm. So there's no way of avoiding harm to sentient beings. by walking, by talking, you breathe in insects, you know, there's all these beings living on us. They're, you know, getting our clothing. If you ate nothing but vegetables, still the transportation of vegetables and the harvesting of vegetables, insects are being killed, right? So what we're saying is samsara is built on the backs of harm, which is why we must get out of samsara. So in getting out of samsara, what are the best choices I can make to support that happening quicker? And if I know myself to not be able to survive without a certain substance, or not yet, or, you know, it's gradual, then what's a way to make it the best choice of a bad situation? You know, so you can make prayers for the butcher. When we meet again, may I benefit them? That creates a karmic link. The next time I meet the animal that was once in this meat, may I be of benefit to them just as their body is benefiting me now. May they have a positive rebirth. I'll do medicine Buddha mantras on the meat and blow on it. May that have an effect on them. And so it's like you make the best choice of the fact that nothing can be perfect in samsara. There are no perfect choices because everything is driven by afflictions and karma. So then it kind of makes you relax, but not so much that you become complacent. You know, you're still checking, am I eating this as medicine or am I eating this out of attachment? And sometimes you are eating it out of attachment, but at least you know that, so it can start to break the habit rather than pretending that you're eating it from medicine when that's not the case. You know, it's like that self-knowledge will start to interrupt the negative pattern. Okay. Yeah, but if it can help us not be judgmental too, if somehow we're like magic vegans. You know, still an apple falls from the tree, it can hit an ant on the way down. Like there's no way of avoiding harm, you know?
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, slowly, but